2019 has been an amazing year on the Common Sense Mamita show. We appreciate every person who subscribed, commented, liked, shared, and made this incredible year possible. Here are some of our favorite moments covering topics such as acting.
Hollywood is full of dreamers, full of people that are not going to, they're not serious. They want to be famous, and that's different than being an actor. An actor is someone who wants to interpret, who wants to take the written word and bring it to life.
Auditioning.
When people say, how do you handle rejection? I go, well, I'm not rejected. It's not rejection, it's selection, which is a big difference. They're not rejecting me, they're just not selecting me.
Branding.
But the problem is, and why I say people don't know what it is people, again, think they need to create a brand and go, okay, I'm gonna sit down and what do I really wanna do? I wanna be James Bond, that's what I really wanna do. But I'm not James Bond. You know, I'm probably the killer that's gonna get killed by James Bond. But brand is simply asking the public what they see when they
see
you.
How they perceive you, not how you perceive yourself.
Yeah.
Content creation.
So if you know they're only casting you this way, can you do your own content? Can you create, you know, your own show?
Today, that's the option, right? Mm-hmm. And it's a great option mm-hmm. for young people. Create your own material.
Because when you're being hired, they would like to cast you in how they see you.
And that is how you're going to be cast.
Hollywood experiences.
You know, I remember an audition late night, and it was one of my first auditions ever, and I read it, and they all said to me, I said, that's terrific. Can you do it again with an accent? And I turned around and I said, so I'm walking down the street, and I saw this lady. She stopped, stared at me, and disappeared. And they were just like, stunned. And I said, you said do it in an accent. Well, we were thinking, you know, more barrio. And they assumed that when you walk in the door, that we can translate.
They're writing.
You can't translate a lot of stuff from English into Spanish.
My Spanish is actors. You know, we're not writers.
Yeah.
Our job is not to translate anything. You give us the material and we do it.
Television writing.
Every writer is different as to what their process is. I do a lot of thinking. I would come up with my best ideas when I'm on a trip, when I'm driving, when I'm showering, anything
other than
sitting there at the computer.
So how
writing.
Do you capture it?
I make notes, jot things down. Truth of the matter is I practice telling my story a lot. It can take me 4 years to come up with something and I can write it in 4 weeks.
Okay, it's marinating.
And you're working it. I mean, that's the other part, is practicing your storytelling craft, is trying it out on people.
Comedy writing.
Try to write a joke a day, and this is what I advise too. Only write what you know, and then what you know, expand upon that by reading something new every day. It could just be one article that you just pull up on your phone. It could be something you want to know about or something that's just right there in the news. Pull up something that's a new fact every single day and try to write a joke behind it. Because at the end of the year, you got 365 new jokes or attempts. And if only half of them were any good, you got 100, and you're the mathematician here, you got 180 some odd jokes.
Stand-up comedy.
People don't know how specific comedy structure is. I mean, a joke, premise, setup, punchline, callbacks. I mean, there's so many things you have to learn. And most people learn it through experience.
Right.
So what we provided them was a time-saving opportunity to cut to, well, you need to do this, you said that 10 times, blah, 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 blah. But mostly what I did was motivate people, not teach them comedy. Honestly, I just gave people permission, you know, and sometimes that's all you need. You need somebody to say, yeah, you can do it.
Producing.
Producing is challenging in the sense that you pretty much do everything behind the camera for the director in terms of making sure that his vision is achieved and making sure that everything is done in a manner that's smooth, where you're keeping everybody happy. You know, you're the puppet master. You got to do a lot of homework, you know, and a lot of good filmmakers on a lot of good films really never see the light of day, you know, because of that aspect of it. Again, I'd like to say it's important for you to know who you hit your wagon to. It's important to know who the players are. Mm-hmm. And that's why legal and agency representation is of the utmost importance. You know, you have to have a great attorney or a great representation or a great producer's rep to really make sure that you and your project ever see the light of day.
Mm-hmm. Financial wellness.
Let's just completely shatter the myth of the starving artist, right? This idea that I have to starve. I have to be willing to suffer, to sacrifice everything if I want to be successful. I think that that's nonsense, and I think that it is keeping artists small. Tied to that is the idea that our money is separated from our art, right? That I'm over here focused on my art, and therefore this money thing has to be something just in the background because I don't want it to distract from my art. They are inextricably linked. And so rather than seeing money as this thing that I don't want to deal with or I have to deal with, see it as what actually supports everything that you love.
Products.
This is great for moistening your voice before you go on stage or before an audition. They have an easy pack that you can bend. It's one portion, so you take a tablespoon before you perform. Carruthers Pastilles, they have glycerin. So the glycerin is from fruit juice, and the goal is not to eat them, to, you know, suck on them, because they're going to coat your throat. Almost every famous musician, you know, in the world uses these before they go on stage.
And self-love.
I did a lot of soul searching and I did a lot of healing, and what really came up was that I had been living my life crisis to crisis to crisis to crisis based on self-loathing. So I was really creating all those crises based on the lack of love I had for myself. So I began to work on loving myself.
We hope you enjoyed this year as much as we did, and we look forward to sharing more moments with you in 2020.